Are you looking for ways to entertain kids this 4th of July? Keep the kids busy and having fun this holiday with these easy to set up STEM activities and coloring pages. Hi, I'm Stephanie Anderson and I show entrepreneurs screen-free ways to entertain their kids while they work from home. Subscribe to my channel and click the bell so you know when I post new videos. When the kids are done running around, it's helpful to put out some markers, crayons, coloring pages, and blank paper. You can create your own with a tracing pad or check the description where I've linked up a few of our favorite coloring pages. So we believe setting up activities that use STEM, which is science, technology, engineering, and math. We also add in art so it makes it STEAM. We encourage all of those activities for our kids at home to keep them challenged and busy and having fun. STEM jobs pay almost double per hour and are growing at a rate of 13%. Let's start with science. So have the kids put together marshmallows and toothpick constellations. This is a great activity for them to do for the 4th of July. Just gather up some mini marshmallows, some toothpicks, you might have to break some of them in half. And we use black paper and just with pencil, we put the most famous constellations there. We added in the little dots for where the marshmallows should go and then the lines for the toothpicks and they can get busy constructing. So even the big kids like this because that means they get to eat the marshmallows when they're done. And it's fun because it almost always happens where they start with the constellations and then they start building towers and structures and the fun can go on for a long time. Technology. So we love the SkyView app. This is an app that allows you to take your smartphone and point it at the night sky. It will find constellations for you and draw them on your phone. So it's a lot of fun for the kids to really see what they were building before and really understand what the constellations are. I'm curious, have you tried the SkyView app before? Let me know in the comments because it is definitely a must do with your kids this summer at night. For engineering, challenge your kids to make firework launchers. This is something you can also make rockets out of too, but what you'll need is a larger straw, a smaller straw, some tape, some scissors, colored paper or white paper with markers. And what you do is you just take the big straw and you snip the end off of it and you tape the end closed. Then you create a firework image. You can color it on white paper or cut out something on the colored paper and you tape it to the back and then you slip the smaller straw inside the larger straw and when you blow on it, it launches. So the kids can have challenges to see how far they can go, how high they can go, all sorts of different ways to make this activity last a long time. And if you do it outside in the grass, the kids oftentimes we'll play this for a very long time. Art. So we've done science, technology, engineering, and now we're at art. So coloring pages are, of course, art, but I also wanted to share this great activity we like to do. It's making fireworks with salt. So what you do for this is you need heavy paper, you need glue, salt, liquid watercolors or regular watercolors. If you're using liquid watercolors, you'll need droppers. And what you do is you start by drawing a firework shape on the paper with glue. And after you've done that, you use a tray or you can do this outside and you dump a bunch of salt on it. And you want to be really like liberal with the salt. Make sure it's completely covering the glue. And then if you tip the paper, you can kind of salvage the remnants of the salt to use for the next project. After you have the salt on it, then you bring out your watercolors. And if you just touch your watercolor to the edge of the salt firework, it will travel along and it kind of like lights up like magic. And so the kids have a lot of fun with this activity. Last is math. So for the little ones, just counting the stars on the flag is a great way for them to count from 1 to 50. You can practice writing on top of the stars if you have a printout of a flag, or you could just have them write the numbers on a piece of paper or even just point to them and count. So counting to 50 is great. For older kids, you can do lots of fun activities with fours. They can count by four, they can use a number line, they can count the stars, or you can do multiplication questions with fours. But tying it into fours because it's the 4th of July makes a fun way to incorporate math into the day. So now you know how to keep your kids busy with STEM or STEAM projects for the 4th of July. Are you looking for ideas for the rest of the year? I have a 3-page guide that you can grab below in the description if you're looking for play activities for the rest of the year. If you like this video, give it a like, subscribe, and share it with a friend, and I will see you in the next one.